I really would like to see how well my reaction time is in this game. I didn't even consider speedrunning it, since it's fairly quick. Oh well, let's go. Casual is gonna be quick as a speed. As a speed game. Ah! Let's go. Nice. That was a good first round. Now, in this, what I'm thinking about in this speedrun, you're gonna have to face these Pharaoh's challenges for about a minute or two. You only have so many lives, so I'm considering skipping the later portions. 6, 7, and 8. Take a life and keep moving forward. Basically be an 80% of sorts, but we'll figure it out as we go along. So here's the first survival round. Minute 40. Not that bad. Of course, you need to find more lives as you progress in the run. There we go. Ah. If you wonder how intense this game is, your roster's right here. You can really see, just one mistake can really cost you. Ah. That's a good stopping point. Nice. Whole bunch of upgrades. 5, 6, 7. There we go. And the first bonus round. Nice. Didn't collect as much treasure, but we're on our way. I think their third stage has... well, third level of every stage. Best darn music in the game. Ah, thought I had that too. I'm actually collecting. I actually have a priority over treasure. That was a good round. Secret level. Just like a Quake. Or in Doom. If you collect enough treasures, you'll unlock a secret area. And let me make sure I can tweet this out again. There we go. Nice. Every secret area based on a classic arcade game, like this one. Ah. Always take advantage when the game slows down. Oh, that's a perfect opportunity. Ah, that was a good round, though. Yeah, asteroids. Most of these levels are from original Luxor games. Clearly a remix of some sort. Oh, perfect. Darn, missed one. There we go. Nice. Why did I do that? My goodness. I have not played this in a long time. So expect me to be bad at it. There we go. Still moving swimmingly. Every fifth level is a dual tournament stage. Ah. You can see, one mistake, you're in trouble. So don't go slow. Oh, nice. Every sixth level is a boss battle. Except in this case, we have another secret level. Very obvious. Yep, the one and only Pac-Man. And ghosts. I don't exactly call him his friend. Perfect opportunity to get some points while we're at it. Oh, darn. Ah. Got another point. Really like the status report in each level. Alright, now we're on to the boss. Trivia, this is not the first game to include boss fights. This is a different boss fight, but error first and game called Quest for the Afterlife. Yeah, your goal in these boss fights is to eliminate the moving spheres surrounding the boss. And occasionally you'll have tanks coming around and surrounding it, trying to protect it. They'll occasionally try and attack you as well, so. Power-ups? No effect. Pretty good music too. When he does attack, you have a chain coming towards your pyramid. What I want to do right here, try and build up your multiplier as high as you can and cash out. Ah. There's the boss fight. Occasionally, they'll leave something behind for you on your journey. In this case, the super power-up. It'll appear constantly throughout each level, so... you'll need to collect a certain amount of them to activate. Like right here. Hey Godzilla, how are you doing? Alright, myself, I'm doing fine. I came back from vacation the other day. I thought I would go up tonight. Oh, that's a good round. Nice. I've had a multiplier in, but that's okay. Yeah, a slight break offline. Couldn't really do anything about it. Alright. That's not a good stop. Okay, never mind. Easy pickings. Darn. Nice round. Yeah, I kind of feel the same way sometimes, Godzilla's. I mean, it's like, I want to play this game today, but... yeah, there's also this feeling, right, like... I have so many games, but I can't decide what to play on. Sometimes you just gotta pick one and go with it. Yeah. That was a nice bonus round. We have another secret level. So if you're unaware, secret levels are actually Easter eggs when you collect enough treasure. And they're based off of a game from the arcade. Path of the Marble King. Marble Madness. And each of these secret levels revolve around the classic arcade era. That'd be a waste of an activation right here. Alright, that's a nice round. Perfect. Just a moment. All right. We're back at it. Just had to do something on stage for a bit. Yeah, Luxor is just something I really enjoyed playing back in the day. And here's a super power up. Yeah, you can expect clones like this game. So really, I think Pause Loop was first. Even though I got into games like Bejeweled and Zuma, Luxor is kind of a spin-off of that. Hang on just a minute. Airnet's been acting all weird. Oh, dude. Oh, dude. Sorry about that. I mean, I was like, okay, thank you. I mean, it was like, Twitch has been acting weird. Twitch and OBS. And the internet. It was like, one day, I was playing Pinball FX2. OBS didn't remind me that I went down. And the chat was like, now hosting some other broadcaster. I was like, I'm still playing. OBS, what are you doing? And then there's time. And then there's the whole dropped frames thing with Time Shock. I don't know, it's been weird. Alright, we're back at it. Yeah, thank you. I forgot that was my game. Ah, that's good. Come on, man. I do not have a PlayStation 4. I have a PC for Stern Pickle Arcade. I thought that was cool. Well, maybe not, but maybe it wasn't a waste. But yeah, I have all Stern Pinball arcade tables until Ghostbusters releases. Gotta take advantage when those sphere. When the game slows down. Apparently, I thought it was an issue, but it was a built-in design. Good round. 10x multiplier, my gosh. This is a really good round. No matter what you do, you can't beat all the table objectives. It really does help the practice and follow all the instructions of a specific table. Well, not necessarily all of them. But still, knowing the rule sets of each game can really help in knowing where each shot is on the flipper. Another secret area. So far we've discovered asteroids, Pac-Man, and Marble Madness. All the Berserkers. Berserk by Stern. I expect to make that. And that was my fault. That was also my fault. Oh, definitely. Alright guys, I have some of these classic arcade games on the computer. Like Atari Vault and the classic Pac-Man and Ms. Pac-Man. Bunch of classics. Luxor Evolved is just a throwback of games from the 80s. It's vector-like artwork. Attack. $300,000 bonus. Yeah, PC users have Atari Vault. Some of the games, or most of them anyway, are Atari 2600 games. I mean, you see how fast these spears are moving? That's insane! I mean, I haven't played this game in a long time. I remember playing this back in 2012, 2013. It was like, I beat this game on Elite Difficulty. I'm playing this right now on Elite Difficulty, and it still amazes me how quickly these field spears are moving. Thank you. better you play, the faster they go. Ah. Some of these games probably fall under licensing, so can't really blame Atari for that. Nowadays they get expensive, and it's probably just not worth it to pursue. Fifth secret level. Spirit of the Tempter. Surprise, it's Tempest. This level has a torque track. It's not a matter of how many levels you have to go through. Your next secret is based off of how many treasures you earn throughout each level. So once you reach the next threshold, you're at the next secret. Yeah, I own a Tempest as well, so not to brag, but I think I have like 127,000 on that game. I totally missed that one. In a situation like this, you're in trouble. We'll be right back. I have 9 lives. It's not a figure of speech. I actually have 9 lives. When his sphere reached the pyramid, you only lose 1 life, so I'll be fine for now. Once you start getting in the groove, they start to speed up. How many levels? Yeah, 6 on each stage, so that's 48. Plus, let's see, 48. Plus 8 bonus rounds if you count them, if you manage to survive each survival level. That's 56. Yeah, at least 56 levels, not counting secrets. Plateau of Obelisks. This one might strike a resemblance. Right there. Preferred male, Pete. I can see that. Twin pyramids. Yeah, a bunch of these levels are from past Luxor games. Good round. Really good round. Mecha Horus. Every boss, you get a tip, so I really appreciate it as it comes. Second superpower up. Incarnation of Horus. Unlimited lightning bolts. Force of Sekhmet is unlimited fireballs. Stage 4. Good collect. Oh, nice. There's just something I like about this game. It really adds this retro feel. And you get this adrenaline rush when you're doing so well. Ah. sometimes I end up off because they just move so darn fast. I've beaten this game multiple times, actually. It's no wonder I'm so good at it. I mean, yeah, it's a throwback to all these 80s games. We're getting another secret level. I mean, it's just amazing. I mean, the original Luxor games. It's same repetitive thing for 88 levels. Luxor Evolved. Oh boy, it's pure adrenaline rush. I mean, I think one finger death punch. Big dog. Ah. Wow! Get that power up. I don't think we're getting any more odds. Yeah, Deg Dug. Good level. Start coming in, you're in trouble. Slow down. Oh boy. That was not good. Well, hopefully we made up for that. Slightly. Good amount of coins in the end. Ah! That moment when you miss. Any more treasure for the next secret? Oh, this is a good round. It's just farming on coins all day. You want to be careful not to claim too many power-ups. Oh. Oh, it's not bad. It's good. This is a good level to farm. Every 30 coins, you earn an extra life. When you see a large amount of clustered spheres, you know it's a good level. I'm not sure if they'll display any statistics, but that was a really good farm. Maybe not. Yeah, I collected at least 10 or 20 in that level. And every extra life at the end of the game provides a point bonus. Yeah, part of scoring high is farming for those onks. Freeze ball. Every stage is attuned to some form of new power up that you'll get. You'll see that in the bonus round. Multiplayer again, man, that was a good round. I mean, you always have power-ups available. What's wrong with that? Oh, I didn't just miss the knife. Oh, now I missed. Okay. That was a really good round. Oh, wow. I remember in my last playthrough of this game, I had 6.7 million points in that round alone. This is really good. And not bad for coming back. Not bad. Another secret level. Let's go. Scarabic invaders. My fault. Oh, I'm in trouble. Blast everything inside. I don't even know why I said that. How are you doing tonight, Tesladon? Immediately right after I say it, I get a laser power up. Fires a freaking laser beam. Everything looking good. Oh, that's a good luck. Fun while it lasted, let's take it down a notch. All rewards unlocked for now. That was a good round. Opening of the mouth ceremony. This game is quite intriguing. A real adrenaline rush, this is. Bunch of quick decisions to make. Trouble. Oh. Laser is actually the most OP power up. Nerf Greninja. I think this level used to be a pain in the butt for me. Oh, this is another good round. Ah! Didn't want that.
Oh,
The last secret of the game. I wonder what it is. And it's Gauntlet. It's Donkey Kong. Multiplier 21? What? Oh man. Someone highlight that. What a rush. What a rush, man. 21x multiplier on this level. I don't think I've ever achieved that. What a level. Ah. color bomb. Four stages after this. 6, 7, and 8. Hopefully we'll have Incarnation of Horus ready to go by 6-3. 6-3 is basically my nemesis crown at this point. Alright, good luck, me. I need this. I'm in trouble. start picking up. Nice. I'll hopefully have cleared out a whole bunch before I start rolling in. Oh, nice. That went swimmingly. Now I need to clear out this whole thing. Oh, we're good. We are good. No deaths. You can see how dangerous that level was. I often lose at least one life on the further I call her. It's often considered 6-3 to be that one level, and rightly so. That was perfectly planned out. Everything still holding up over there? No dropping frames, audio, everything good? Oh, this is another good farming level. Assuming I actually... Alright, great, thank you. Just making sure everything's still good. That was a good level. 18 lives. Mecha Raw. Enraged boss can attack without spinners. So these are the spinners in front of the... Chain. No power up can harm it. Darn. Double darn. That was my fault. Aspect of Raw, the third and final super power up. Onwards, 7 and 8. Gears can speed up, but they can also slow down if you're not doing as well as you think. I'm in trouble. There we go. Out of there. Seven, two. Oh, that's a bad color bomb color. Okay. Acceptable. I want to be careful. Here can be out of control. Like that. Like that. Oh, perfect. Ah! Good round. Chain it for us. Hopefully I didn't miss anything. Alright, we're good. Shooters and ladders. That happened. I'm not sure if that turned out to be profitable or whatever it was freaking laser beam. Oh, I remember this. This set of stages is a cluster of sphere stages, or cluster of trains. They go real fast. There we go. That was fast. 100% accuracy, just in case. Oh, this is another good farming level. Combo. What a round. Just want to know, are we still online? Alright, we're good. Yeah, it's sometimes I get fooled by the dashboard. I'm watching the dashboard closely. Sometimes it's saying it's offline. And I'm just having a close eye on things, so please bear with me. Boss has 4 fuse. Can attack at will. Okay. Good opportunity. Boss is currently disabled. He cannot attack for a period of time. Sadly, the scorpion cannot fly. Just sadly. And even with the spinner is gone, he can still attack at will. Last stage, let's go. What a ride this has been. Though. Nice. Persevere. Forest is shocking impact. Nice. Perfect bonus levels. Nice. Alright, Nile Libations. Good luck me, again. Another level that can really go wrong. Wait. I needed those two super power-ups. Ruins of offset. This is one really long chain. That was quite tense. Yeah. What multiplier was that? Either way, that was a really good level.
Ah.
grenade out, so I'm not really afraid to power up here. Oh, that happened. Okay. Okay, running lightning storm is very risky. Oh, extra life. Go out of there. Let's go. Final boss. Mecha set. Hello? Showing signs of weakness. G freaking G, man. Ah. And that's the ending credits. Yeah, 103 million. They don't call me Infinite Eternal Champion for nothing. G freaking G, man. What a run. Keep in mind, this is also a no life loss run. It was a fun extra. The playable ending credits. Missed 132 shots. Max chain. Never had a nine. Huh. Flawless victory indeed. Yeah, thanks everyone for watching and all the support. Topped by about 17 million, nice. Yeah, thanks everyone for all the support tonight. We're gonna find someone to host.